going on, aquatic family? My name is Ryan from the Aquascape Gods on Instagram. So today I've been driving on my way home from work, and actually I'm not really driving, my car is driving me home from work because it's self-driving. So first of all, I want to know how many of you would trust your car to drive you to and from work? How long is your commute? And what do you do for a living? I want to get to know you guys. But while I've been getting driven home from my car from work, I was thinking maybe I could do a video on one of the most controversial things that I talk about the most, what Eric and I do, kind of as a practice that we use, is using sand as a substrate instead of the, you know, traditional aquasoil. So a lot of the issue is people that are getting into the hobby, they start DMing me and they say, what do I need? I have aquasoil, I have all this expensive gear, I have all these lily pipes and whatever. And really, it comes down to the simple fact that you don't need aquasoil. You can get away with using just regular sand and still grow pretty much everything that you see, anything on my page. I have a million examples, especially Rotalas. Rotalas grow really well in sand alone. And the way that it works is you have to dose fertilizers. So if you don't have all the other things that are going along with the sand, then yeah, maybe it won't work for you. But in my experience, plants are opportunistic. So that means that they will grab nutrients and fertilizers any way possible. So that means through the water column. So I dose the water column with some sort of an all-in-one substrate, with some sort of all-in-one liquid fertilizer or powder fertilizer. I've used both of them. They both work perfectly fine. And this is a big thing that helps me just kind of keep everything simple, because sometimes when I'm using aquasoil, I don't like when I'm changing something up and the mud gets everywhere and there's dirt all over and it takes a day to filter through the filter and get clean again. Sometimes I like the ease of just using regular plain old sand, having it nice and easy where I don't have to really do so much work to keep it really clean and pristine. So that's kind of where I'm at with sand versus aquasoil. It's not really that serious of a change. The only thing you really need to worry about is getting your CO2 and getting those fertilizers inside of the water column. But I will admit that when you have aquasoil, it does help out a lot, especially when you're using heavier root grabbing or root growing plants. That's what you want to call it, kind of like AR minis and any type of crypt. You're going to want to use aquasoil most likely, although it's definitely not mandatory. A big reason why a lot of people don't like aquasoil and they don't want to get aquasoil is because they don't want to spend the money. I mean, aquasoil can be expensive, and it is. Really, no matter what brand you get, it's going to be pretty expensive. But, you know, if you have a hobby that you're really into and you want to spend some money to make it as good as humanly possible, spend the extra couple dollars, get the aquasoil. It'll make your life a little bit easier. But I'm just saying, you don't need aquasoil. You can get away with using an inert substrate just like a regular sand. All you have to do is just buy some sort of a liquid fertilizer for $7, pump one or two pumps in there a day or every 2 days, do your water changes, do everything like normal, and it will work out perfectly fine, most likely. I also am obsessed with my aquarium, so I do keep up with my maintenance really well, and I think that's really the key to success. If you're not really consistent with your water changes and your trimming and every little thing that goes into the hobby, your tanks aren't gonna be as good as they possibly can. So any soil you want, as long as you're doing the work, it shouldn't be that big of a difference. And the only difference between aquasoil and sand, besides the nutrients and everything, is the money. And it depends on what you want to accomplish with that scape. So I like the look of sands better than aquasoil. There's gotta be so many reasons why you could do either one over the other. A lot of people will put soil in the back and then they'll put sand in the front. And I've always kind of been confused about that, but then I realized people have always been trained, not trained, but they've always thought that it's like mandatory. They've always thought that you need some sort of substrate. So I think I'm gonna start getting back more into the sand substrate just because it's a lot easier for me personally to do. I like the way that the sand looks with the plants in it. I've done it with my Rotella tank. It's I called it like the stem plant tank or the I forgot what I called it, but it was a cool tank. It was probably my favorite tank, and there was no root tabs, there were no soil, there was no anything really except for just dosing the fertilizers and, of course, CO2. So I hope this video kind of gave you an idea of something that you could do that's not the norm. You don't have to do what people say will make a successful planted tank, but it's up to you. Give it a try. Let me know how it goes. Drop a comment, drop a like, and subscribe to our channel. We're posting a video every single day. I hope you enjoyed this self-driving cruise vlog type of video. If you did, just let me know at the bottom. Don't forget to let me know if you would trust your car to drive you home. All right, until next time.